Let's see how you do under pressure.
Right, Aki Karima, BBTV. I'm here with Mikey Gomez Jr. What's that? You've been doing sprinting today? You've been working out today?
Yeah, mate. Every day this morning, though, we went on the hill sprints and had big Marky Taylor dinner at the top. Can give me pure abuse, mate. Making me go faster and making me do extras. Kept it sliding, mate, right at the end. Thought it was done. It made me go again. So, yeah, mate, not been the best of mornings, but we're here.
Do they ever throw stuff at you just to, like, add an extra thing into your training? You've got to dodge it.
They give it the old speech of, you know, extra points and that extra wins and that, you know, getting one over them and that. Like, the only person I'm getting one over is myself. It's only me sprinting. You boys are at the top telling me I'm getting an extra win. I'm not winning myself. I'm going to me anyway for a win or lose against myself. So, yeah, mate, he just shafts me. Yeah, he had me on the hills this morning and then I finished and he was like, yeah, go on, off you go, back down. So, yeah.
Well, it's nice to hear that you're working hard because you've got an interesting fight coming up, Cain Baker. It's, when I seen the fight straight away, I thought, well, explosive. You know, you're both characters and you're both exciting to watch. So do you actually like the fight? Did you like the fight when it was put to you?
It's gonna sound bad this, Aki, but I've never really watched him, I'll be honest with you. Like, I'm gonna at some point, but I know what he's about. I've seen bits of two fights, not fully watched them. When he boxed Akin Fiab, obviously, because we used to train at the same gym and obviously knew of Akin. And then the Jordan Flynn, is it the first, second fight? I don't know, but they boxed not long ago when it was a draw, yeah, didn't draw, they? Yeah. And I knew that was meant to be an eliminator, so I'd watched bits of it. I think it was even out. It might even have been out when I was watching it, so I didn't watch it fuller. But yeah, so I've seen bits of him. He's a version of me, but probably not as good ability-wise. And I don't think that's wrong in saying that. I think if you don't agree with that, you're probably just hating on me. You know, in terms of with meathead on, but actual ability-wise, Aki, let's shot selection. I am a better fighter. That, you know, that's not disrespectful. I think that's a genuine fact.
So with that being said then, are you seeing this as it's a big platform, obviously, on DAZN. I think it's your first time on DAZN.
Yeah,
it is. Are you taking this with that mindset? Are you taking this as just an opportunity to shine and to get signed by Eddie Hearn, for example?
Listen, mate, I'm not even... It's gone to the point now where I don't even think about getting signed, thinking of this and thinking of that. Because this boxing game, it's pretty shit in it, let's be honest. People say things that's never true, and this happens, that happens, and things just never happen, mate. So it's about beating Cain Baker, and like I said to the man then, apparently it's meant to be an eliminator for the British. If it's true or not, I haven't seen it in black and white, but that's what I've been told.
Eddie Hearn's got the champion.
Yeah, well, that was what I was about to say. Yeah, you know, come through this, I can't see why. That, if not, I'll have to have one more fight. Then, mate, that's like I said to the man. Then again, that's all I turn pro for. I can be British champion. I never said I'm going to be world champion. I'm never going to be uni. I'm not delusional. With the style I fight and the way I fight, there's going to be ups, downs, left, rights. It's just this genuine fact, mate.
Well, that's why we like watching you, to be fair.
Yeah, my aim was to win that, mate. Once I win the British title, then listen, you can put me in with anyone after that. Once I know if I'm good enough to achieve what I want to achieve. Then after that, it's a barrel of laughs for me after that. And I'm just going to go out there, try and make as much dough as possible, keep my family happy, and that's nice, mate. But until I have that crack at that, I'm not going to talk about fighting this person, calling that person out, doing this, doing that, because it just doesn't make sense right now.
Okay, fair enough. In your one, well, the fight with Levi Giles, obviously a bit of a fiery build-up. with Cain Baker, I mean, obviously Levi's quite a calm dude, you know. Cain's up for it as well, you know what I mean? So is this going to be that type of a build-up, do you think? Or do you think, well, you're going to have to save it for fight night, but...
Yeah, there was personal things being said back and forth from people on that side on social media that brought a few things, they were saying a few things that made it a bit like, I don't think... Listen, unless Cain doesn't like me, which I don't know if he does or he doesn't, unless he makes it personal, this isn't personal for me, I'll be truthfully honest with you. I'm going to go out there and I expect to beat him. I expect to beat him. Not easier, because he's never been beat easier, but I expect to win, and I win comfortably enough. And even being truthful, I don't see it going a distance. I don't. Listen, I'm not saying that he can't stop me, because with me, when two things bang head to head very fast and very hard, one of them's going to come off worse. And listen, I'm cool with that. Listen, if he does that to me, I won't sit there and say, oh, it was this and it was that. Fair play to him.
One thing, I don't know if you've been asked this yet, but obviously you're known for your Mexican style. You've got the Mexican ring walk, the way you fight. But he's actually training out there in Mexico with and had Mexican sparring partners.
Out there, is he out on all day? Who knows? You know, it's all right saying, you know, I can post, if I go and post a picture, if I post a gym picture in the gym tonight and it's warm, can I say I'm in Puerto Rico? It might be on holiday. Who knows? Like, I don't even, I have no interest in what he's doing. He could trade in Mexico. What's, if he's doing that for the first time, he's never done it for any other fights, that's a compliment. Because then he wouldn't have lost all the other fights, or whatever fights he's lost and drawn and whatever else, if he was doing them for them fights. So if he is just gone out there purposely just for to fight me, then I appreciate that. That's, you know, I have more respect for him, because then it shows that he's rating me highly, so fair play to him.
And I know you fought at Manchester Arena before, or the AO Arena as it is now. I mean, that was your pro debut, was there, wasn't it? Or front of the Frank Warren, yeah. But
I'm like a little slag now, really. I've been a Warren show, a Sky show, and now this one. So yeah, I'm basically just a little brass now, basically.
But it is good that Eddie Hearn's bringing boxing back to Manchester, because, you know, we are a boxing city, so it is good. And this, you know, really speaking, it is, he is an astute promoter. So if you do well and you're exciting, the likelihood is he could ask to sign you, especially having the champions, the British champion.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not even going to say he might. They never do. Do they? People say what they listen. It seems like he's genuine. It seems like he's honest. Listen, all I want to do is earn my shot. I don't care if I have to fight when I eventually get my shot at the British title. If it's going to be on, it could be on car park on BBC One. Like, honestly, the platform, that's the goal, that's the only aim that's left for
me.
Yeah, that was just the first thing that came to my head. What's it called? Dave or something like that? I don't know. Any channel. But yeah,
David Hay was on Dave.
There you go, that's what I want to be on Dave. Yeah, listen, so that's what the aim is for me now, just to get on, just to get that fight. Not even Dave's Reese Blotty. I called out Liam Dillon for 12 months, you know, that's. Not because, again, it was nothing personal. That's just what I want left from the game. Like, once I win the British title, and I know if I'm good enough to achieve what I want to achieve, then I'll sit down and talk about any fight. Like, fighting someone doesn't, you know, it's no obvious thing that I will fight anybody. It doesn't matter to me. But there's no point in me being stupid now and calling out him. I want to fight for a world title. Because realistically, right now, I'm miles off that in terms of I'm fighting for defending England's title. So there's no point in me pretending to want to skip levels and trying to get. Let me get where I want to get. Let me get the British title. I believe I deserve a shot. This is now my fourth domestic fight, an area title defence, an area title fight, an English title win, and an English title defence. Not many people do that. Let's not sugarcoat that. How many people? Don't forget, I'm meant to be. Apart from the Olympians, you know, these people who have uncles and dads and brothers and cousins and whatever else. As you know, ex-boxers, you know, they get a nice build, they have a nice platform, don't they? They come through. I've not had that. I've had to do it the hard way. I'm not saying that all the fights I've had domestically have been hard or should be good names, but mate, I've still had four. This is still my fourth one. I'm not had a crack at the British or Commonwealth title, mate. That's, I'm not saying it's unheard of, but it's not. You don't see that every week, do you, mate? I'm not had it either. So I think after I win this fight, come through this fight, I think I deserve it more than anyone.
That's some very interesting and fair points, and you have done it the hard way. And
that's a genuine fact. I'm not saying go through Boxrec and find people, because there's probably loads that have done it, mate. But I'm talking, I can't think of many who have had to win the area title, defend it, win the English, then defend it without having a shot at another bigger title. Considering that my dad was meant to be like a, you know, he was a big name, but you know what I mean. I've not had the. Yeah, well, like, you don't have to defend that belt. You can go, you know what I mean, mate? I've still had to defend my belts. I've still done it the hard route, mate. I've not had one easy. This will be my fourth. So if by the time I do get that window come through this and they do get the British title shot, that's five domestic fights just for a British title, mate. That's mental, mate. That's like mental.
Well, when you put it like that, let's hope that if anyone influential is watching, they give the winner of this fight, if it's Mikey especially, give him his shot that he deserves.
Kane probably deserves. I'm not saying that Kane won't deserve a shot, but you got to remember as well, Mike, he's got this fight off a draw and a loss. I know people are saying they're controversial or whatever, but on paper, the bottom line is a draw and loss. If that was Miyake, do you think I'd be on an English title fight? That's not, again, I don't want people to feel sorry for me or moan for me, but that's a genuine fact. If I came off a loss and a draw, there's not a chance to say, yeah, there's a fight that you go into as a, you know, you might get beat, but it's a fight that you've got a chance in. There's no way that'd happen. If I was to lose this fight, you're talking at least another 12 months before they give me another title fight. Guaranteed. I mean, I'd probably have to go back down to the area title level. I'm not playing victim or blaming anyone, but that's a genuine fact.
No, Mikey, you raise some very interesting points, and it's always good chatting to you. Yeah, truthful points, and it's always good chatting to you. And I'm looking forward to this fight in the build-up. We're quite far out, really, realistically. But looking forward to fight week.
Today, mate, I'm fucking tired, mate. I've got a 5 week old at home, mate. We had
congratulations.
Mate, the dog was up last night, and the baby, the dog was up doing some weird choking thing last night. So yeah, it's everything. We've been training camps, mate. So I'm good. But listen, I'm fight week. You know, the energy is different, the entertainment is different. But right now, mate, I didn't want to be here really. I didn't really want to be here though. Kev made me come. Let's just put it out there, Kev.
No, it's all good, mate. It's all good for the building up the show.
Listen, it's good. It's fun, but I'm not here for that. I don't really care about this stuff. I like you, Aki, so that's why I do interviews with you. But interviews, I'm not a celebrity. I don't want to be a celebrity. I don't want to be a famous person. I don't want to be in the limelight to people. I want to just turn up on a fight night, get in the ring, be as violent as I can possibly be, win or lose or draw, then go home and live my life till the next one. That's all I want to do, Aki. I don't care about anything else.
And that's why I follow the journey from day one, mate. It's always exciting and great to see you as well.
Like, that's not even, like, that's a genuine thing. I don't really care about cameras, interviews. Like, it's not going to change my life, is it? Like, it doesn't make a difference. All I want to do is turn up when I've got to turn up, do what I like to do. That's my break, mate. That's what I enjoy, doing it in the ring. That warmth in the changing room's there, thinking, oh, shit, this is going to be bad. I like that, mate, thinking, oh, I've not done that run that I should have done. That sort of stuff, that's what excites me. Other than that, I'm not bothered about anything else.
Good to speak to you, Mikey. I'm looking forward to what you say on the stage. Top man.
Hopefully enough.